Are you experiencing the joys and complications of relationships, or even have hidden regrets? Then come join me, Lady Anna, every Wednesday from 6 p.m. to 8 p.m. Eastern for Lady Anna's Musical Mix, where I'll be playing selections of pop and soft rock ballads. So let the music alter your vibration by evoking positive and emotional chills and thrills within you. Join me this and every Wednesday on UVC Radio, the sound that binds us together. Yes, I promise
you. UVC Radio. I could start dreaming, but it never ends. As long as you're gone, we may as well pretend. I've been dreaming straight from the heart. You said it's easy, but
good afternoon, good morning, and hi listeners. So welcome back. This is Lady Anna's Musical Mix, and I said we are celebrating our first anniversary. So yes, so thanks again to all those who sent in your greetings, Auntie Listra, Auntie Jean, Vilma, Mr. Placid. Thank you guys so very much, Rodney, yes, for all the greetings and wishing us all the best and lots more success. And listeners, again, thank you all very much for tuning in to our UVC Radio 1 channel, our YouTube channel. Continue to subscribe to the channel, share, like, and view. And I'm sure you all are hearing a voice in the background. So welcome to Straight From The Heart, as it's the first anniversary of Lady Anna's Musical Mix. We will be introducing a new segment, which will be aired the third Wednesday of every month, Straight From The Heart. So let me introduce to my co-host for these segments, none other than King Rocco HD, the man who is burning the midnight oil here at UVC Radio. So King Rocco, welcome to Lady Anna's Musical Mix and Straight From The Heart.
Oh, definitely, Hannah. It's a pleasure being in the hot seat with you this evening and stuff like that. Excuse my voice, kind of a bit under the weather this evening to our listeners, but you know what? Nevertheless, we are here, and definitely it's a pleasure, you know, being in the program this evening. How are you doing?
Well, I am very well, very, very well, thank you. And it's really, really a pleasure to have you here with me to discuss what we are going to discuss today. So listeners, our topic today, Straight From The Heart, we will be discussing, is kissing important in a relationship, whether you are dating, whether you are married, or, you know, just for fun or whatever. So we are going to be discussing that, yeah? So I believe Rocco has a clip to play for us before we get into the meat of the matter.
Yeah, definitely we're going to get to that shortly, but I want to say a big shout out to everybody tuned in right now. My dad down there in St. Vincent and the Grenadines is actually locked in right now. Good evening to you. I say hello to all of Vincent and people and all our listeners down there in Trinidad and Tobago, New York. He's in the house at the moment, Houston, Texas, Michigan, the UK, Kingston, Jamaica. Yeah, definitely want to say hello to each and every one of you. You know, as you rightly said, this is a new segment in the Musical Mix. And, this is just the birth of it right now. And I'm sure it's going to be, with time goes by, you know, it's going to grow and it's going to get big and, you know, great and stuff like that. So, yes, we definitely got a clip, but momentarily we're going to get to that.
But you know, Rocco, as you said, we birthing this baby today. Our listeners should know that this segment, Straight From The Heart, this baby has been in conception for quite a while, more than 9 months, almost years in the making. And finally today we are doing the delivery of this new segment and this program. So I am
most certainly
thrilled to be doing this. Yeah. Okay, so as we're doing kissing, why is kissing important? We would like to play a clip for you guys about 5 sexy ways to kiss. So let's take in the clip.
Let's talk kissing. Your skill as a kisser is an incredible tool to be able to create connection, attraction, and desire with your man. So in this video, I'm going to share with you 5 sexy kissing techniques that you can use that will make him hot for you. Now, I know that you have probably had some bad kissers in your life as well. And I know guys need a lot of help as well. So I'm going to share with you 3 things not to do first, and then we'll talk about 5 sexy kissing techniques. First thing not to do is don't be a slimer. And you've probably experienced this where someone's not just kissing your lips, they're actually kissing your whole face. They're like swallowing your chin, leaving saliva and slime all over your face.
What happened? Are you okay?
He slimed me.
That's great! Actual physical contact!
If your man has to do this after kissing you, that's a slimer. The second thing not to do is don't be a propeller tongue. This is where the person opens their mouth and it's just all tongue, and their tongue is like on a search and discovery mission, right? If the tongue is trying to clean the tonsils, that is a propeller tongue. No good. And the third thing to avoid is what I call turtle lips. Like, this is where the lips are kind of hard and chapped and there's no supple softness to them at all. It's just all, it's like kind of a kissing a brick chapped wall, right? It's no good. It's not sexy. So now that we have the things to not do out of the way, let's talk about the 5 sexy kissing techniques that you can use to help make your man hot. The first one is to build tension. And this is where you lean in for the kiss and then you pause and you let him anticipate the kiss. You let him desire you. You build up that tension right before you kiss. Will Smith in the movie Hitch describes this perfectly.
See, the secret to a kiss is to go 90% of the way and then hold.
For how long?
As long as it takes for her to come the other 10.
Okay, 90-10. Got it.
Yeah. Okay, come on. Shake it off.
And you can use this too, where you lean in and you just let him feel your breath and you hold right before you kiss, builds that tension with him. Number 2 is to start slow and soft. There are those moments when you can just rush in and have that passionate, hot kiss. In the beginning, start slow and soft. Let your lips be supple, let them be soft, and don't go right for the tongue. Just start using the lips in the beginning because it sets up number 3 really nicely. Number 3 is change the pace. Just having a pace change signals to him something interesting. It signals variety. It also signals increased turn on in you, and when you get turned on, he gets turned on. So here's how you do it. As you're starting slow and soft, and as you're getting more turned on, increase the intensity, increase the pressure. Move from the lips to the tongue and back to the lips and the tongue, and press into him with your lips. Tilt your head from one side to the other side as you increase that pressure, and that's going to signal to him that you're getting turned on, and that in turn turns him on. Number 4 is to gently brush your lips against his lips. This is not where you're actually kissing him. This is where you sort of take a pause, or you're changing it up again from the intense kiss and you're pausing, and now you're just grazing your lips against his lips on the outside, just the edges of your lips touching together. And he's not only feeling that beautiful sensation, but he's also anticipating the next kiss coming. And lastly, number 5 is to don't just use your lips and your tongue, but use your teeth. And go in and kiss him, and as you're kissing and kind of sucking on his bottom lip, bite his bottom lip with your teeth and kind of pull a little bit. Now, you don't want to hurt him. You don't want to do this.
Ow, ow, my lip.
Sorry.
Now, if you hurt him, you take a chunk out of his lip, he's not going to like that. It's going to be a turn off. But it's going to be a turn on when you actually use your teeth. You kind of graze his bottom lip, pull on it just a little bit. It's going to make him super hot. So there you have it. 5 sexy kissing techniques that will make your man hot for you. Now, I have a question for you. How do you want to be kissed? What can a man do to kiss you in a way that totally turns you on? Post that in the comment section below. And if you're not subscribed to this channel, we are dedicated to helping you increase love in your life and experience love in deeper, more fulfilling ways and achieving the dreams that you have for your life. So if you're not subscribed, take a moment, click the red button, get subscribed to this channel because we've got an amazing community of heart-centered women dedicated to expanding the love in their life. Thanks so much for watching. I'll see you soon.
So, listeners, welcome back to Lady Anna's Musical Mix. And as we are discussing, is kissing important? And you know what? We all start somewhere. And let's get real. You know that kissing can be totally awesome, or it could be super cringeworthy. But without a doubt, a great kiss or makeout session can leave you feeling pretty darn amazing. Don't you think so, Rocco?
Oh, most certainly. Definitely. I totally agree with that.
And you know that science even suggests that kissing can actually be great for your health. Because a small study in 2009 found that kissing can even reduce perceived stress. But of course, we must admit that some kisses just aren't great. But if you had a few of those yourself, remembering them might make the idea, you know, of swapping spit with another human seem a little less ideal. I don't know what you think about that, Rocco.
Oh yeah, that is so true. I mean, some cases and stuff like just aren't great at all, you know. So, but according to the research that you just read, you know, it is very important. It's really good. It's really good for your mental, as well too, in terms of releasing stress. Yeah, absolutely.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. And, you know, listeners, are you wondering where you fall on the kissing spectrum? So no need to worry, because today we are going to share some tips and tricks with you that can help you actually improve your lip game. So, you know, Rocco, one of the
things... So talk to us.
They also say is that you must be prepared before the moment comes, and we can't always control when the mood for a kiss strikes. But what we could do, a little preparation can go a long way. If you know when you're out with your date that kissing might be on the agenda, or you want to put it on the agenda. For example, if you're going out to dinner or something, you might want to skip the garlic bread and onions at dinner. What do you think about that? You know, depending.
Oh, man, most definitely, man. You know what I'm saying? It's like, you can imagine going to dinner and stuff like that. And somebody that onion or the garlic and stuff like that try to come kiss you. Oh gosh, that can be a big turnoff, man.
Yeah, it can be, yeah. Or you're even getting it on your breath and that kind of thing, yeah.
Yeah, definitely. It can definitely be a big put off and stuff like that. So definitely want to encourage ladies or guys. I mean, y'all going on a date and stuff like that, especially the first time. Stay away from that garlic and stay away from that onion. It doesn't really have a pretty good taste or aroma, especially going to kiss somebody.
Yeah. And then another thing is, you know, that dry or cracked lips is not really appealing. So what we could do, make sure you always have some sort of lip balm or so with you, especially for those of us who live
absolutely
in the cold winter. Yeah, especially during the winter times, you know. So the lip balm can help you avoid chapped and peeling lips. So
make well, sure that as well, to always keep yourself hydrated by drinking water.
Yes.
Yeah, water is very important as well, too, because what water does, it actually keep your lips kind of moist, you know.
And, you know, for a pre-kiss touch-up, the good old gum or breath mint would not hurt.
Oh, there. Ooh, absolutely. Hey, that could be pretty horrifying, man.
Yeah. To make sure, you know, that the mouth feeling fresh and clean and that kind of thing. And then, too, if some persons are worried about their breath, there is nothing wrong with taking a quick trip to the bathroom to brush your teeth, you know, freshen up a little bit. So
absolutely. You know, this is a very serious thing, to be honest with you, because I mean, a lot of people sometimes, you know, they suffer from bad breath, and you know, they don't realize it. They don't really realize it, you know. And you know, the funny thing, especially those people, those who are, you know, who actually suffer from this bad breath, they are the one who always in people's face.
So
hey guys, make sure you get some mint or something, or get some Winterfresh, or hey, or if you know you got bad breath, make sure you got your toothbrush always along with you, even if you go to a restaurant.
And then, you know, another thing, when you're going to kiss someone, make sure it's not, you know, always you read your partner's body language and so, and make sure that that person giving you the right cues, and make sure that your situation is kiss appropriate, because not everyone is comfortable with a kiss on the lips in front of a family member. But you know, maybe a smooch on the cheek or the forehead might be perfectly sweet. You just never.
Well, yeah. You see, again, this is going to come down to communication and stuff like that, and knowing your partner, because, I mean, to me personally, if, you know, if I got somebody and, you know, I'm trying to kiss you and stuff like that, and I'm basically going to be like turning aside or want to kiss you in the forehead, I mean, to be honest with you, that's some red flags right there, man. I mean, no. I don't think we're really getting down like that, because if I'm your boyfriend, I'm your girlfriend, your wife or your husband or wherever it is, you know, I think it should be neutral. And likewise as well, it's all about knowing your person that you have.
So let's just look at, you know, think about when you're going in for a kiss, right? So it's like, not just, you're not going to go in for this kiss like when your partner just tells you, or your partner has just told you, you know, my dog just died, or they now admitting to you that they just failed a driving test or an exam or something, you know. That is probably not the right time to
go in. At that time, your mental is not in the right state, so, you know. Yeah. Because all you're just thinking about it, oh my God, my dog died, or I failed my driving test, or something. So at that time, you got to be a little selective, maybe, you know, thinking, well, you know what, this is not the right moment. So it's all about the timing, and as well, so I'm still going to say communication still is a big factor, and all about knowing the person that you are in your life.
And as you rightly said, communication is the key, and these days, I don't know about you, Rocco, but I find couples kind of like lacking where the communication is concerned. People just like this quick text texting thing, you know, just a couple words instead of sitting face to face and having a real one-on-one with each other and get your feelings out and let people know how you feel.
Yeah, absolutely, you know. No longer people can really communicate and stuff like that. You know, some people just show action. It's like sometimes they figure, consider, you know what, man, you should know what I'm, you should know what I need. You should know what I want. I ain't got to say to you. So it's no longer the days people can actually talk with each other.
Yeah. And some persons, you know, sometimes we look at consent and respect. And when we speak about consent, it's not all the time you're going to come out right before you kiss somebody. Hey, can I kiss you? You, as you rightly say again, the communication. You speak to the person, the individual, and you would know if you have consent to kiss them at whatever point in time. So when you're coming in for that kiss, you know that you're not going to get turned away. And
I ain't trying to set yourself up.
Yeah. Because sometimes movies and these TV shows might make sudden surprise kisses seem so romantic. But it's essential to actually have someone's consent before you actually touch them and, you know, go in to kiss them and sort of thing like that. Because like we say, the mood might be just right, but you can't know for sure whether someone actually wants to be kissed, though, unless you probably read the physical, the body language.
I just about to say that. I just about to say that, because sometimes, not every time you gotta, you know, actually say the word. Again, it's still gonna come down to knowing your person, because body language can say a lot, you know. It can definitely say a lot.
Yeah, because like, just imagine, right, you and your girlfriend or you and your date, you're cozying up in a corner of your favorite, maybe dimly lit hangout or something, and you guys talking about how long you've been crushing on each other, and your knees keep touching and you have to move in close to hear them talk, so you're actually whispering now in each other's ear and you can't look away from them, and suddenly they break off mid-sentence to ask if I could kiss you. The tone in their voice tells you that that is all this person has been that's all this person has been thinking of. And that sometimes, you know, sort of like breaks the momentum and the trend of it. So you had to be reading that situation, right, if the person...
And again, sometime, you know, you don't have to even say it, you know. One of the things with chemistry is very important, because, you know, if two people are dating and stuff like that, you know, they just... Well, they just get to know each other. Let's say maybe a few weeks or whatnot. The more you speak to each other, the more you get to know about each other. And you know, possibly you go on your first date and maybe you want to kiss that girl, or the girl want to kiss that guy. Just possibly just talking to each other and stuff like that, you know, you can definitely feel that energy, you can feel that vibration, you can just feel that chemistry. When the chemistry start to flow and stuff like that, you know, everything just so spontaneous, everything just start flow naturally without each person actually say this is what they want, they would like.
Yeah, that's a nice way, you know. And as you say about each person's, without saying what you like, when in a relationship, it's important, because sometimes you might feel perfectly fine with your partner surprising you with kisses. Just to let them know, you know, sometimes that it's okay, you could kiss me at any time. And then sometimes if you're in doubt, it's important to consider the type of kiss that you're going for, because you know, sometimes showing affection in public without full blown PDA, instead of doing that, why not, you know, try a quick peck on the shoulder while you're waiting in line, you know, maybe to go into the cinema or something like that while you're holding your popcorn. You know, you just drop a little kiss on the shoulder or something like that. You're standing behind her and maybe your hand on her waist or you're holding her hand. You know, you just drop a little kiss there.
Well, that's what I see as well to Lady Anna. I'm still going to call back. Communication is the key, and this is the base, because both parties need to know each other likes and stuff like that. Because, okay, so whatever, for example, I'm going to put myself there now. So whatever, for example, now, okay, hey, we're going on a date. Okay, you know, I don't know your likes, your dislikes, and stuff like that. And then, you know, I consider, you know, especially men always like to shoot their gun. And I decide, you know what, hey, I want to kiss you. And maybe you're not that kind of type who love this kind of affection, this kind of lovey-dovey kind of thing, this kind of touching all of each other and stuff like that, you know, these hugs and whatnot. Maybe you're not that kind of person. What happened now? It's a recipe for disaster.
Disaster.
So communication, yeah. definitely, it is the key to know each other wants, the needs, the likes, dislikes.
Or then, you know, even if you're out in public, you wouldn't go for the full blown effect, as they say. You try a little and see.
Well, some people do. I mean, I personally don't see nothing wrong with that either. You know what I'm saying? Some people are quite reserved, and some people are quite spontaneous and, you know, bubblicious, like to do stuff all day. And, you know, I can honestly say I'm one of that kind of individual. I don't see anything wrong with that, doing that in the public. Not at all.
Okay. Well, I guess you will have to communicate that with your partner before you get out into the public.
Well, yeah, definitely. I mean, I'm saying, I think it's normal, especially the days that we're living in and stuff like that. I mean, everything is public, man. I mean, people all... life, everything is all social media. I mean, it's no longer people really have secrets again.
That's some people, not everybody, but
well, absolutely, absolutely. But if your partner is quite out there, you know, spontaneous, and then you more of a introvert, and your partner is an extrovert. That can cause some problem, you know what I'm saying? Because basically, nine times out of ten, what is going to happen is like, you know, the extrovert will always try to get the introvert to come him or her way, you know? That's going to always happen. Why the introvert will just settle for whatever, you know? It's not like maybe settling for less, but it's just that certain things you just don't make a big fuss out about it. You content with whatever come your way, you're just going to deal with it, whatever. But of an extrovert now, extrovert always want to see themselves doing things. Always want to be spontaneous. Always want to be out there. You know what I'm saying? I can safely admit that to the public. I'm that kind of person, you know. I'm an extrovert. That's the kind of person who I am. So, yeah. So, you're dealing with like an introvert. That could lead up to some sort of issue. But it will not be an issue if both party actually talk about whatever it is that each other like or dislike and stuff like that. You know, something called compromise as well, so because by the same token, even though you may be an extrovert, you can't always be, always want to be on top of everything, you know what I'm saying? Sometimes you just got to just chill sometime and just let the good times roll, because you being, you know, the trendsetter as an extrovert, always want to be in everything. Sometimes what that does as well to the person who is the introvert, it kind of destroy them mentally. You know what I'm saying? Because in their heart, in their head, you know, it's like, you know what? All right, you always call the shot. You know what I'm saying? I'm going to just go with the flow. I mean, whatever you do, I'm going to follow suit. You know what I'm saying? And that could definitely be a big, big, big issue. So at the end of it, both person need to communicate, need to say what they want. If you're not going to say what you want, man, it doesn't make any sense at all. Y'all better just trash it.
Yeah, and I like the idea of the compromise. You meet each other halfway, because there are some places where, okay, yes, you could show that PDA, and then there are some places where you meet halfway. Okay, listeners, so at this time we will take in a couple of tracks and we will be right back. So stay stick and stay with us. It's Lady Anna's Musical Mix, and we are celebrating our first anniversary. This is a special segment which will be aired the third Wednesday of every month, and it's called Straight from the Heart with my co-host King Rocco. Take it away.
Yes, indeed. Yes, indeed, people. You're listening to Lady Anna's Musical Mix. This is an addition to the Musical Mix. This show, this segment called Straight from the Heart. You listen to UBC Radio, the sound of binding us together.
Maybe I dream too much, but when I think of you, I long to feel your touch, to whisper in your ear. That I hold as time, words only you would hear, if only you were mine. I wish I could go back to the very first day I saw you. Should have made my move when you looked in my eyes, 'cause by now
this is Raul James from outer Kingston, J.A. I represent the King Rocco HD on the UBC Radio every Friday night. Why? This and every Friday, 8 p.m. Eastern Time, 7 p.m. Central Time. They say, King Rocco, better than them, better than them.
And I promise you that we deep inside, just to walk right up to your door. But my body can't move when I finally get to it, just like a thousand times before. Then without a word, he handed me this letter. Read, I hope this finds the way to your heart. It said,
please say you love me.
Yes, indeed, people, we are here. You're listening to the Lady Anna Musical Mix. I'm your old King Rocco HD. And Lady Anna's somewhere in the studio, running around in the studio. Yeah, so momentarily we're going to definitely be back in the studio, all right? So this segment calls Pray From The Heart.
Nightly, beside the green, green grass, swing, swing, swing the spinning step. You wear those shoes and I will wear that dress. Oh.
Listeners, so welcome back to Lady Anna's Musical Mix, and we are live on UVC Radio, the sound that binds us together. So as one of our listeners says, from Trinidad, Maruga, she is enjoying the conversation about kissing. She never knew all this stuff about kissing, wishing her days when she was dating or courting, she had the experience of being kissed all over. You just never know, some public displays of affection. You know, sometimes we must hear from some of our listeners who are really, really matured in this kissing business and what it was like when they were much, much younger, you know, compared to today, as we say, the millennium kids. So let's look at, you know, Rocco. I know this is something that you would like really, really much.
Right on, man.
Are you ready for some foreplay? So,
hell yeah.
You know, a lingering trail of kisses on the neck can leave them, well, you know, trembling. Yeah, I guess you have tried that. So remember, you don't have to plant a kiss on the lips every time. You could start slow, and building up the tension can often be a better option than coming on strong from the beginning. Once you have the basics down, you are ready to make your move. Because, you know, friends, listeners, loyal listeners, our listeners out there in Brazil, I know that you will definitely agree that kissing does not have to be stressful. If you are worried about getting it right, always start with the basics. You know, Rocco and I will say with kissing, there's no right way and wrong way.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
Anything wrong, yeah? You have to try, experiment, and see what, you know, works for you.
Well, I always say, you know what I'm saying, being spontaneous is always a good thing, you know what I mean? You don't want to live your life a dead life, you know what I'm saying? And then, when you meet at a certain point in your life, then you're going to consider yourself, you know what, I wish I was young, maybe if I was young, you know, I wish I could have turned back the ends of time, I would have done this. Listen to me, man. Even though you may be up in age, you can still do what you gotta do. Still rekindle
exactly.
Your youth. You know, who say? Even though you're up in here, you can't still do the foreplay. You still can't be kissing and stuff like that. Who said that? You know what I'm saying?
Exactly.
You see, one of the things, right? And society always intend to make people believe, like when you meet to a certain age, you are done. You know what I'm saying? You're no longer relevant. You no longer can get married. You no longer can go on date. You know what I'm saying? I call it stupid thinking. You know what I'm saying? Because I believe, as long you have life and you have what it takes, hey man, you still could do it.
Exactly. Nothing wrong with persons in their 60s and 70s having a little relationship and enjoying a kiss or two.
You could imagine, right? You see some, like a 80-year-old couple basically going on a date. Everybody going to be like, you're going to turn a lot of heads back and like, man, what's up with these people? Why do people just go home? I just chill. I leave this for young people. You know what I'm saying? Absolutely garbage, man. Anybody can
do it. Exactly. And there is no age limit to kissing.
Certainly not.
Yeah. Once they could read the situation right, because with your body language, you could move in a bit closer. And we're just giving a few little tips here, right? So you could cup their cheek, or use both words and actions. You know, you just lean in. In case you're feeling a little bit nervous, don't rush it. Especially if you're not sure which way to tilt your head. You know, for the young lovers who are not going to do this for the first time, or even whatever age you may be and you're going to do this for the first time. So what you do? You dip your head or gently guide your partner's face to the side. And you know what? Listeners, if you are worried about banging foreheads, you don't need to stare them down. But a little bit of eye contact can help. And so you make the initial movement less awkward. So you just ease into it. You go with the flow. So you start the kiss out simply with slow, gentle, and light pressure. And just in case you want to continue the kiss, to build it up, lengthen it, try varying pressures slightly. You can also shift your focus from their top lip to their bottom lip. And remember, a little pressure goes a long way. Keep your mouth relaxed and try not to force your pucker or kiss too hard. But you know what? In case you're in doubt, Rocco, you know what the best advice is? Just mirror what your partner is doing. Since
therefore you should just follow, just go accordingly.
Yes. Since most people tend to kiss in a way they enjoy, so just think of a good kiss as an exchange, not just one person running the show. So it's two people, you give and you take. So you use your hands, and you know the hand placement is really important, because sometimes it may feel a little awkward at first, but you just do what feels most comfortable for you. So you try slipping your hands around your partner's neck, and that's if the person is like about the same height with you. So you could try stroking their hair or moving one hand, you know, to each place, maybe the shoulder, but just in case there's a height difference. You can always rest your hands on your partner's hips or lower back. But you know what, listeners, just don't overthink it. You just go in with the flow. And if you want to move from a closed mouth kiss to an open mouth kiss, once you're ready to kick it up a notch or two, you just go, you know, you just ease into the kiss with no effort at all. So, Rocco, let me pause there before I get into the top notch. I am sure.
Well, you sound like an expert, man. You sound like an expert.
Okay, all right. So, we have a voice note from Vilma. Let us hear what Vilma is saying to us this evening. So let's go with that.
Just shouting out happy first anniversary to Lady Anna on her music mix. I enjoy your program every week. Keep up the good works. Love you. God bless.
Okay. Thank you, Vilma. Thank you. We receive those blessings from you. Thank you so very much.
Yeah, absolutely. You know, again, it's all about knowing your partner. And you know, one other thing would encourage persons as well to the world that we're living in today. We're living in a technological era whereby you can go all over the internet and find information, whether little video clips or material that you can read. And even though you may not have personal experience when it comes to certain things, especially like the whole foreplay thing, the whole kissing thing and whatnot, you can definitely go and read, man. You know what I'm saying? Read. You know, you talk to other people as well, and that's the only way you're going to get information. But I'll tell you this right now. No matter what information you have read, no matter what material, no matter what you have watched, if you never had one-on-one personal experience, it ain't say much.
Sure, right. Yes, so
it ain't say much at all, you know what I mean?
Teacher, yes. And you don't have to go around kissing a million girls or a million guys. You kiss the same person once you are with the same individual. You kiss the same person and you experiment with your tongue, your lips, as we listened in the video. You know, the five sexy ways to kiss. So there are different ways to do it. We just didn't get into French kissing and all that sort of thing tonight. But this is just the basic here about kissing. So the important thing is just make
definitely
your breath in order.
Definitely.
Yes. Yeah, so... And then sometimes, you know... Just again, when you're kissing, don't get into all this saliva, exchange of saliva, because not everybody like all this saliva going back and forth in their mouth. So again, as you rightfully said, Rocco, you communicate, because after you do something and you try it, it is important to talk with your partner. Hey, did you like that? Do you want to try something else next time? Did I bite you too hard? You know, sometimes all these sort of things happen. So it is important.
But you see, as well, to Anna, we got to understand. A while ago, we spoke about introvert and extrovert. A person could be quite positive sometimes because, you know, some people, you know, they may not like it, but they would just sit there and just don't say anything. And like, yeah, it was good. It was good. But, you know, deep in the heart, deep in the head, you know, like, oh, gosh. This dude was horrible, man. This chick was horrible. You know what I'm saying? So, I mean, by doing, instead of doing all of that and, you know, deep within yourself, you're not happy. Basically, what's going to happen, you're going to ruin your own relationship. So,
exactly.
Guys, let me tell you something right now, man. You know, if it's something that you don't like, whether him or her, y'all better communicate. Y'all better tell each other, you know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. What is good or what is bad. Because if you don't tell me if it is bad, you know, there's no way. If you're not together, I'm in a relationship. If you don't tell me if it's bad, you know, there's no way I can know whether it's bad. You know what I'm saying? Speak the truth. You know what I'm saying? Speak the truth. Let both parties know where you're at. So on that note, by saying all of that, at least you can have a smooth standing in the relationship. Then, you know, both parties have to be deeply involved in something. And then, you know, at the end of it, the other partner aren't happy at all.
Exactly. And when it comes to communication, whether you are an introvert or an extrovert, that should not count and that should not matter, because the communication is key, because you are going to ruin your relationship if you don't talk and explain your stories. You may not be able to explain it in as many words as, but you know, layman's term. I liked this. I did not like that. Can we try something else next time? This was painful. I enjoyed that way when you did it. This brought excitement to me. I got the chills and thrills when you did this. So that is really, really important. Yeah. Yeah, yeah. Yeah. Yeah, because when you get into the kissing aspect of it, that's like a whole language of its own. Something else just takes over and the feelings start to flow and you're in a different flow there, man. Yeah,
man, that can lead to so many different stuff, you know.
Mm-hmm. Really great stuff.
Oh, yeah, absolutely. It goes without saying. Goes without saying, people.
Yes, once the chemistry is there. You just shoot for this stuff.
You know, it's a chemistry rising, temperature flowing, you know what I'm saying? Yeah. Everything flows.
Yes. Definitely. So, and so, you know, we did discuss the sexy ways of kissing. Well, at least we heard it in the clip, so if we want, we can just go through that briefly. So listeners, before we get to that, let's go to another song track. So Rocco, you take it away for us.
Can you keep a secret?
Okay, so we are going to hear from Celine Dion, If Walls Could Talk. Take it away.
These walls keep a secret that only we know. But how long can they keep it? Control. We're two shadows chasing rainbows behind closed windows. Behind closed doors, if walls could talk, oh, they would say, I want you more. They would say, hey, never feel like this before.
Can you keep a secret?
So welcome back to Lady Anna's Musical Mix and Straight from the Heart with my co-host King Rocco HD. As I said, he burns the midnight oil to keep things running in this place. And a very warm good evening going out to Cool Cucumber. She's listening on. She is one of those individuals, hardworking, quietly behind the scenes. So Cucumber, you continue to be cool, yes? And greetings again coming from our listeners. They are wishing Lady Anna's Musical Mix great success, continued support from our listeners, and they want to see this musical mix grow from strength to strength, prosperity into prosperity, and many years to come with much bigger and greater things. And wishes coming from Lystra, who resides in Brookfield in Trinidad and Tobago, Mama Mala, her entire home circle, Papa Kedal, Sarana, Carissa, Lena, aka Pretty, Caitlin, who is Little Pumpkin, and also not forgetting Auntie Mary from that marketplace out there in Maruga, sending us blessings. And Auntie Mary sent a comment. She said, you know, when you're going in to kiss, don't even bother about tilting the head and bumping the head and stuff like that. What you do, just close the eyes, go with the flow, man. And you never know, you could just take a peep right sometimes and see what the lips doing, and look at each other and smile and get back down into the kissing, right, Rocco?
Yeah, that's what's up, man. That's what's up. Big up yourself. Big up yourself, Miss Mary. That's the way it is, you know what I'm saying?
You know, and sometimes some people might ask, is kissing important in a relationship? And
I would say yeah.
Yes, most definitely, because it builds emotional intimacy. It banishes stress. Yeah, and it's responsible for bonding. Hello, when you hug and you kiss, that bond, it strengthens that bond between two people. And it plays a very, very important part in attraction. It boosts the trust. Rocco, when you sit down and get into a real intimate kiss with somebody, don't you feel that you could trust that person?
Yeah, definitely, man. It's just like people talk about sex and talk about kissing and stuff like that, you know. It's more than a physical thing. It's intimate, it's spiritual, it's very deep. Because basically when you see the kisses and stuff like that, what it does, it actually creates a bond with that individual.
Yes. It's an expression of love. And it's fun. And
Oh yeah, certainly it does.
Yeah, it does. And kissing is one of the most exciting things when you're building a relationship with someone. It is so new, it's electric, it just sets off that fireworks, you know, between the both of you. and all that takes place, you know.
Oh, absolutely.
Trans and stuff.
Absolutely.
Yeah, with all the oxytocin and all those, you know, those things. And then, you know, a kiss could mean so many different things. It could mean an apology, it could mean a comfort, it could mean a hello, and it could also mean an innocent gesture, you know.
Oh yes, definitely.
Yeah, and it is the main thing, how you connect with your partner in your romantic relationship.
Yeah. It is sentimental, it's in depth, it's a lot of emotional attachment as well. So because remember, you know, a while ago you speak of the exchanging of the life and stuff like that. So remember, man, you exchanging the life with somebody, that's deep, man. That's deep.
Yeah, it is. And you know, the other person's alive when your mouth is, it, some people may know it. It is good health-wise, eh?
Oh, it is. It is. It is. And, you know, a lot of research actually show and say, you know, I mean, exchanging of the saliva, it's a very good thing.
And no matter what kind of kiss you use to give, even a simple smooch can do the job. So at not all times it has to be an intimate kiss, you know. It can do so much for you,
man. It makes your day.
So
you know what I'm saying? yeah, it definitely makes your day. You can imagine, especially
someone.
I mean, you're a youngster going to school and stuff like that, and I mean, girl kiss you, I mean, or guy kiss a girl, I mean, it's just like one of them $1 billion moments.
So as we're talking about, you know, how it builds the emotional intimacy, and so it's one of the way that couples develop an intimate relationship with one another, and it is a way where they could be vulnerable and comfortable and deeply connected with each other in a relationship. So, you know, that's very, very important, because when you are emotionally intimate with your spouse, you're able to connect with them, you are able to share secrets with them, and you are able to tell them your fears and feel completely accepted by them. You're not being judged, and that's important.
Connection, really important. Definitely.
Yeah.
Because tell you this, right, and you can't love somebody without being connected. And that connection definitely is the key. Yeah, it is the key.
You know that. Okay, so they say kissing is a very important form, you know, because it helps with the physical and the intimate part of it, but the oxytocin hormone released while kissing helps lower emotional barriers and connects a couple on a deeper level. So I guess, you know, as we're talking about the oxytocin levels there, people, go out and get your partner. Even if you haven't been kissing, go out, get your partner and start kissing. Okay, it has tremendous health benefits to it. Okay.
Everybody, y'all better go out and start kiss, but be careful who you're kissing. You don't get yourself in trouble, people.
Yeah, and start banishing some of that stress.
You know, we all live in a difficult time right now. We definitely need to release some of that stress, man. So, hey, go give your partner a kiss right now, man.
Yes, exactly, Rocco. And we are going to end off on that note, where we are encouraging all you lovers out there, even if you're not speaking with your boyfriend or your girlfriend at this point in time, you all had a little argument, a little knick-knack, pulling and tugging, hey, call them up, text them, drive over, go knock on the door, you know, and look at that body language, start kissing.
Absolutely.
So, yes, so listeners, this has been your first episode of Straight from the Heart on Lady Anna's Musical Mix. This segment will be aired the third Wednesday of every month. So it is a new segment, so you can look out for us again with another interesting topic. All right, yes, 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 and again, you can check us out on our YouTube channel at UVC, United Vision Connect. So that's UVC space radio, RADIO space figure one, numeral one. UVC Radio 1. Check us out on our YouTube channel. You just never know. New videos being uploaded each and every day, and you can subscribe to our channel, share the videos, like them, view them. And thank you all so, so, so very much for all the views on Lady Anna's Musical Mix. We're, you know, we're counting down the views. So viewers, listeners, thank you all so very much. And King Rocco, thank you for being with us here on the Musical Mix this evening. Listeners, remember.
Oh, definitely. It's been a pleasure sitting in the hot seat with you this evening on the Straight from the Heart program. And as you rightly said, you know, every third Wednesday of the month, you know, listeners can definitely pause for this segment. And definitely, definitely, I want to say I appreciate you.
Okay, yes, listeners. So you can join me on a Sunday morning from 7 a.m. Eastern Caribbean time for 2 hours of sunrise praise right here on UVC Radio, the sound that binds us together. And remember, you are known, you are noticed, you are loved, and you are blessed. Have a good evening, everyone. And thank you for joining us today. Stay blessed.
Yes, indeed, people, you've been listening to Musical Mix, segment Straight from the Heart, Lady A. In the meantime, between times, stay tuned on Top of the Hour, that we in the United States, Serbia, for extra great talk. So long. Peace.